Jodie Duffy, Prime Local News.
One of Huskisson's major landmarks is about to undergo a $25 million facelift. The owners of the old Husky pub, now to be known as Jervis Bay Resort, got the nod from Shoalhaven Council last night to turn the well-known watering hole into the largest residential development approved in the city's history. Coming up after the break in Prime Local News, BHP run their Olympic flag up the pole and the Burger King chain open for business in Shell Harbour. Welcome back. After months of lobbying, more than 500 canisters of capsicum spray have been made available to the New South Wales Police Force. The non-lethal self-defence device has been under the spotlight for months after several recent attacks on police officers, including the fatal assault on City Constable Peter Forsyth. 11 police regions have been issued with the spray. Local weapons instructors are now training field officers in their use. Properly applied, capsicum spray can totally immobilise an offender for 45 minutes. Officers forced to use the spray in the line of duty will be required to justify their actions. Tenders for the full-time supply of the canisters close at the end of this month. The Big Australian today kicked off its involvement in the 2000 Games with the raising of a gigantic Olympic flag at the Port Kembla Steelworks. SOCOG representatives led by Sid the Platypus welcomed BHP aboard the Olympic bandwagon. And later in Prime Local News, Michael Jordan appears at the snake pit, but not the tall, wealthy one. Next is Patrick with all the sport.
Thank you, Kerryn. Coming up, basketball news and the national surf titles kick off with the Masters on the Gold Coast. Good evening. Basketball first up, where the Illawarra Hawks are believed to have re-signed coach Brendan Joyce. The details will be unveiled tomorrow, but it's tipped to be a new three-season deal. But now to the surf. The Rule's Darren Mercer defends his national Ironman title at Kurrawa Beach on the Gold Coast later this week. Today, our Masters competitors had their turn. And finally, all the best to the lawn bowlers at Nowra, the ladies' club celebrating its 50th anniversary today. Kerryn.
Thanks, Pat. Next up, I'll have all the weather details, and then a Wave FM April Fool's joke brings Michael Jordan fans to the snake pit. Well, much cooler throughout the region today. It's around 17 in Wollongong right now and 19 degrees in Eden. Taking a look in the north, the temperature dropped to 9 in Goulburn overnight, climbing to today's high of 25 in Goulburn. Further south, it got down to 9 degrees in Maroombula and reached a top of 23 in Batemans Bay, Bega and also Maroombula. And the Bureau predicts we're in for another mild day tomorrow. The forecast for the Illawarra, fine and mild with variable winds. The further outlook, fine and warm Friday, Saturday and Sunday. For the Highlands, early frost patches, then a fine day with light winds. The outlook, warmer Friday, fine and warm Saturday and Sunday. And on the south coast, fine and mild with fresh southwesterly winds tomorrow. Another fine autumn day forecast on Friday. Tomorrow's temperatures, Wollongong 14 to 22, 12 to 22 in Nowra, 2 to 20 tomorrow in Goulburn and 8 to 23 degrees in Bega. And the boating conditions, southwest to southeasterly winds, gusting to 15 knots, seas to 1.5 metres. The tides, there's a low at 6:45 tomorrow morning, the high tide at around 12:45 in the afternoon. And finally, for those of you who missed it, Michael Jordan made a flying visit to the snake pit today to shoot around with the Illawarra Hawks, his presence leaving many dumbfounded. Once again, the top story in tonight's Prime Local News. 2,000 mourners have filled St Mary's Church at Berkeley today to farewell Catholic priest Father Maurie Crocker. Priests from all over the region and a friend, the Bishop of Broome in Western Australia, attended the service. To close, students march today through Wollongong. Good night.